Welcome to this video on the calculation of volatility skew.
Volatility skew exists in the volatility surface. For out-of-the-money options, which are equidistant from the at-the-money options, the out-of-the-money put options IV is higher than the out-of-the-money call options IV. But this can be subjective. We need to devise a method to quantify skew rather than looking at the volatility surface graph.
How do you quantify skew values?
The first step is to calculate the put option IV and call option IV. This you can do for all the strikes for a particular expiry date. If your data already provides IV values, this step is not required. You can directly use those values. Then, you select an out-of-the-money call and out-of-the-money put option.
Which out-of-the-money strike price to select?
One method is picking the options whose strike prices are 10% from the at-the-money option. In the graph shown on the screen, the at-the-money strike price is 5,000. Thus, the out-of-the-money put and out-of-the-money call options with strike prices of 4,500 and 5,500 can be selected.
Why did we choose 10%?
The reason is that we don't want an option which is too close to the ATM option or far from the ATM option. Therefore, you can select the out-of-the-money options, which are between 5% to 12% from at-the-money options. This range is a function of the volatility profile of the underlying asset. We have selected 10% in this video. A more advanced approach would be to work with multiple out-of-the-money options. You can pick a range of options away from the ATM strike price and calculate their average. Thus, you will choose a set of OTM put options and calculate the average of their IV values. This set could be 5 options in 5% to 12% from at-the-money options. For example, we have taken 5 OTM put options as shown on the screen. If you take the average put option IV, it will be 18. Similarly, you will calculate the average of OTM call options IV for a set of OTM call options as shown on the screen.
The average value is 13.
Great. You have calculated the average put options IV and call options IV. Now you will calculate the skew by subtracting the average implied volatility of the call options from the average implied volatility of the put options. But wait, you have to standardize these skew values as well.
Why should you standardize the skew values?
Standardizing the skew values helps us to compare the skew values across time periods, as well as with the skew values of other assets.
How do you standardize the skew values?
You will divide the difference in IV of the out-of-the-money put option and call option by the ATM IV. Since the ATM IV is 10, the final skew value will be 18 minus 13 divided by 10 is equal to 0.5, or 50%. A limitation of the advanced approach is that the selection of the range of options is arbitrary. Also, market conditions or volatility profile can change, and this might not be adequately captured by the static range of options selected.